deviation at all, all the students have scored 40. There is more strong information in less. Right? Therefore, we need another set of observations, another set of constants called measures of dispersion. Measures of dispersion. That is second set of dispersion. Before we go to dispersion, now you take medium. If you say take a series of values, median is the center bend. Right? This is not coming under center tendency or dispersion. This is called positional averages. A lot of time we use to interpret the positional averages. So median is a position. It is in the middlemost value. Below which 50% of the value, suppose if there are 100 students, median is the mark below which 30 students have scored, above which another 30 students have scored. This divides the whole series into two parts. There is another set of positional averages you have to understand called quartiles. Which divide the whole series into four equal parts. Right? So Q1 is the first quartile below which 25% of the values are available. Suppose if the marks are ranging from 0 to 100, it is not the 25, it may be mark, maybe 35, 36, below which 25% of the students, 15 students would have scored. Median is the value, maybe 56, 70, whatever it may be, below which 50% of the students score. This is Q2, and Q3 is the value below which 75% of the mark the students have scored marks. This is called quartiles. Then we have octets, which divide the whole series into 8 equal parts. 10 times also there. Please go through this percentiles, this is very important. Percentiles. We should divide the whole series into 100 equal parts. The center will be P50, which is equal to Q2, which is equal to median. Right? In a lot of competitive examinations, what happened? Some students used to come, sir, my percentile value is 92. 92. What does it mean? How to interpret that? Suppose if this P92, what does it mean? 92% of the students scored marks below his marks, below his mark. Remember, it is not 92. When you say that your percentile is 92, P92, which means that is the percentile below which, that is, he is in the top 8%, isn't he? Top 8%, below which 92% of the students would have scored. Suppose it is P10 or maybe say P8, which means below him 8% of the students would have scored. Other students would be the 92%. That is the meaning of percentiles. Deciles, that is 10 equal parts. Octiles, 8 equal parts. Quartiles, 4 equal parts. This is called positional averages. So this is about the average. Then if you go to dispersion, the extent of deviation of the individual values from the central value, the first, like average, first we have range. That is just maximum value minus minimum value. Suppose in a class of 60, you are conducting a test, marks ranging from 0 to 1. If your range is 90, what does it mean? The student would have scored 0, another student would have scored 90, range is 90. Or 10 or 100. So range is 90, maximum minus minimum value. This is one Second one is mean deviation. You don't worry about mean deviation. It's again a statistical concern. Quartile deviation. Q3 minus Q1 by 2. Q3 is the third quartile. We don't take the maximum and minimum, but we take third quartile, first quartile, we find the average. Very powerful measure is standard deviation. This is a very powerful measure of dispersion. The central tendency mean is very powerful, best average, and in dispersion, standard deviation is very powerful. Don't bother with the formula and other things. See, we say that it's not, I gave an example that all students 0, 0, 80, 80, and 40. I told that 40, 40, 40, and 40. Your mean value equal to 40. Here also mean value equal to 40. Here standard deviation will be 40. Here is 0. If you really calculate, this will be the value. How to interpret that? Here in this case it is very simple. 40 plus 40, 80 will be the maximum value. Then 40 minus 0 or 40 plus 0. 40, there is no deviation at all. It's a wrong. It is a very, very wrong interpretation. In general, if you take x bar plus star minus sigma, that is 0 to 80. X bar plus sigma, 80, x bar minus sigma, 0. So we expect that the values are expected to lie between 0 to 80. There should not be much deviations around that. But theoretically, not all these values, only 67% of the values, these integer values, are expected to lie between this 1 sigma limit. 0 plus 1 sigma, sorry, mean plus 1 sigma. Then the mean plus 1 sigma, 0 to 80, only 67% of the values are expected to lie. If we widen this width, 95% of the values are expected to lie. 3 sigma, 99% of the values are expected to lie. How this 99, 95, you see after probability, right? So this x bar plus r minus sigma is the range, or it is the width within which these individual observations are likely to happen. Right? This is about the standard deviation. It's a very powerful measure. This will be used further in all other analysis. See, this has got very important applications. It seems to be very simple measure. See, in textiles, I tell you, the last the process, you know, they used to sell yarn of particular count, say 60s, 70s, 80s, is around the count, that is thinness of the yarn. And they used to sell it, you know, the average weight of that particular yarn, you know, per kg maybe, 1 kg or 2 kg, 3 kg will be there. Suppose if it is a 5 kg bundle, you know, then for 60s, I would like to find out what should be the total length of the yarn. 60s count, if it weighs 5 kg, what should be the total length? Say for example, 5000 meters. 5000 meters. The long from here to here, it may be 5000 meters. When I buy 100 cones, one cone is 5 kg. So he will put all the 100 cones, weigh it, 5 into 100. If 500 kg is there, I will buy it. Right? But this is the old days. 500 kg, okay, weight is correct, I will buy, pay the money. And in another bag, again 500 kg and all that. So here, the average weight is 5 kg because 100 cones into 5 average is 5 kg. We don't forget about the length. 500 meters. But now the specification is, I want 5000 meters plus or minus 0.5 meters. Plus or minus 0.5 meters. If you individually weigh, it may be 5 kg, it may be 6 kg, it may be 4 kg, but on average, it will be 5 kg. Practically, when I take and put it in my loop, it must run up to 5 meters. More than that, it is a waste. Right? Then another count I used to take, another bundle, it may be 5,010 meters. There will be another thing where it will be 4,995 meters. Average is same, 5 kg. But if I take and put it in the loop, what happens? These type of differences will be there. But I have to cut the lowest length. What will happen? All these things will be waste. That may run into 10 kg, 15 kg, 20 kg, we don't know. So I want consistency of this 500 meters. Otherwise there will be a huge loss. This is a situation where our average weight will be misleading. That is why there is another very strong measure. We normally use it as CV percentage, coefficient of variation. Very strong measure. The simple formula is standard deviation by mean into 100. The interpretation is lesser the coefficient of variation, more will be the consistency. Suppose if there is no deviation at all, if all the students they score 40, 40, 40, and 40, there is no deviation, the CV will be 0. So lesser the coefficient of variation, more is the consistency. Suppose there are some cricket players, there are some consistent players, 75 runs they score, 75, 70, 72, 77, 78, consistent players. There may be some other players they score century, 100, 120, 0, 5, again 85. They are not very consistent. So consistency says to what extent individual values are very close to the mean value. Very close to the mean value. You can ask, standard deviation does the same thing. It is not like that. It should be a relationship to be with the mean value. That is why sigma by x bar into 100. In interpretation, what happens? Suppose this is always less than or equal to 0. If it is more than 0, so more than 100, what happens? Sigma by x bar CV, if it is more than 100, what happens? More than 100. Your sigma will be more than mean value. If sigma is more than your mean value, that means there is a huge deviation. That is a situation where it will be more than 100 because it is expressed as a percentage. We should be very, very careful. More the coefficient of variation, more will be the deviations. Nowadays, if you go to a textile mill, when you are 100 cones weighing 5000 kg, 500 kg, when it is coming out, there is a slip where there is an average weight, maybe 5 kg, then your CV is also attached. If the CV is more than maybe 5% or 10%, they will reject the entire lot. Or in the purchase or the division, the computer will automatically reject it. To that extent, this application has gained momentum. Or otherwise, you put one bundle, 5 kg, then another 5 kg, you see both the values, x bar and sigma, if you put another